Hello everyone, you're watching Physio Classroom channel, and in this series of educational videos we will be covering the assessment and treatment for hemiplegia patients based on the concepts of Bruunstrom therapy. Bruunstrom therapy approach was developed by Signe Bruunstrom, who was a Swedish-American physiotherapist. Her work in the field of adult neurorehabilitation, especially in hemiplegia management, was recognized worldwide. And her assessment and treatment concepts were published in the form of book in 1970 as Movement Therapy in Hemiplegia. Still, the Bruunstrom therapy approach is being taught across schools and universities of physiotherapy worldwide, and students and practitioners still refer to these concepts of treatment while managing patients of hemiplegia. So let's first understand what is Bruunstrom therapy. Bruunstrom therapy basically is a neurophysiological treatment approach that has been conceptualized from two important theories of motor control, namely the reflex control theory and the hierarchical control theory. So let's first briefly discuss the reflex control theory to understand the Bruunstrom approach to hemiplegia management. The reflex control theory states that reflexes are the building blocks to complex motor behavior and movements. And the second important thing is that afferent sensory inputs are the necessary prerequisites for producing an efferent motor output. So let's take up an example by which we can understand how this theory of motor control can be utilized in treating hemiplegia patient. So now let's say we are seeing an acute hemiplegic patient on day 1 or day 2, and patient is in the flaccid state. There is no reflex activity and no movement. In such a situation, the Bruunstrom therapy states that we should first utilize treatment techniques to facilitate reflexes on the paralyzed side, because then only it will be possible for us to gain movements or motor control. Without facilitating the reflexes, without giving the afferent sensory inputs on the hemiplegic side, we cannot expect purposeful efferent motor outputs or movements. And this is one of the reasons why we see contradictions among the Bruunstrom therapy concepts with that of other neurological treatment approaches like the NDT. Like for example, NDT therapy says that the therapist should devise strategies to prevent development of abnormal tone and reflexes in hemiplegic patient. On the other hand, Bruunstrom states that early reflexive activity should be considered as a normal process of development, and the therapist should try to facilitate and utilize these reflex activities to develop movements in hemiplegia patients. This will become more clearer when we will discuss and practically demonstrate the Bruunstrom therapy techniques in our upcoming videos. So now let's briefly discuss the hierarchical theory of motor control. Now, hierarchical theory states that central nervous system is organized in a hierarchical level to control the motor functions of the body. So students can here appreciate the motor control hierarchy. So we have the cortex on the top, followed by the midbrain, and then the brainstem and the spinal cord. Now please remember that all these three levels have capability to produce or facilitate motor movements on their own. But in a normal individual, the motor functions of the midbrain and brainstem and spinal cord are controlled and regulated by the cortex. Now it is interesting to note that even in normal individuals, we can see certain motor behaviors at subconscious or reflexive levels that are mediated and processed at the level of spinal cord and brainstem and midbrain. Now, like for example, if somebody is cooking and hand suddenly touches a hot object, then what we see is a sudden reflexive withdrawal of the hand from that particular stimulus. This particular motor behavior is mediated at the spinal cord level. Similarly, the coordination between the head and the eye movements, or the writing of the neck on the body during turning, is mediated at the midbrain level. Similarly, the equilibrium reactions which are responsible for maintaining the center of gravity within the base of support is mediated at the cortical level. So let's say, for example, for the past few minutes I am delivering a lecture, but not for a single second I was thinking about maintaining my own balance for standing. At all times, my cortex is able to process the sensory information that is being received from the proprioceptive and exteroceptive stimuli and utilize them in the maintenance of equilibrium at the subconscious level. Similarly, the other thing that we need to understand is that complex motor behavior or movements are processed at the cortical level, and we are able to produce variety of movements. Whereas in the absence of cortex, the midbrain is able to produce only less complex movements which are not multiplanar and are more stereotypic in nature. That is, the ability to produce variety of movements is lost when only midbrain is active in the absence of the cortex. Whereas when only we have the brainstem and the spinal cord as the motor control center in the absence of midbrain and cortex, then we can only produce reflexive movements. So this is what the Broomstrom emphasizes as the road to recovery in hemiplegia patients. So if we have an insult to the brain and there are no motor movements that are being produced, so first the therapist should try to facilitate reflexive movements that are mediated at the brainstem and the spinal cord level, followed by more complex movements that are mediated at the midbrain level. So we have upper limb flexor synergy, extensor synergy, and similarly we have the synergies for the lower limb which needs to be facilitated at the midbrain level. Now once the patient gains control over these movement synergies, then Broomstrom recommends that we should now progress the patient towards producing more complex motor behaviors which are to be mediated at the cortical level. So in this introductory video on Broomstrom therapy, we have tried to understand the important concepts that are being utilized in treating hemiplegia patients. So in summary, Broomstrom talks about the development in reverse that happens when an individual suffers from stroke or an insult to the brain. In such a situation, there is loss of higher motor control centers, and so the therapist should first try to gain control or facilitate movements at the level of the brainstem and the spinal cord, and then gradually progress the patient to the higher levels of motor control. In our second video on Broomstrom therapy, we will be talking about the basic limb synergies, and we will discuss the upper limb flexion and extension synergies in detail. So see you all in our next video. Till then, keep learning, keep sharing, and stay connected.